Hello and welcome to another Rome 2 unit spotlight. This week we're focusing on missile cavalry. All cavalry skirmishers rely on their dexterously fast hit and run attacks. The idea is to get in close, loose off a few volleys and quickly withdraw out of reach before any counterattacks can be made. This was the main role of ranged cavalry, both in support of infantry and pursuing foes on the run. The nomadic tribes culture pack has a wide variety of missile cavalry units available. Known to the Greeks as Scythians and to the Persians as Saka, the exceptional horsemen of the steppe constituted a formidable force. They lived in an area that spanned from the Caspian Sea all the way to the northern shores of the Black Sea. The Scythian royal skirmishers may have a short range, but pack a real punch. These elite skirmishers will pierce even the most heavily armoured of units. Saka cataphract horse archers are incredibly tough, with a longer range and a faster rate of fire. This is thanks to the composite bows that they wield. Constructed from layers of wood, sinew and animal horn, this bow required strength and practice to use effectively. It had to be kept dry, which is why the majority of military campaigns were fought during the summer and autumn. With a wide range of ammunition types available to missile cav, knowing when to use each one is crucial. Heavy shot increases damage but reduces range and accuracy, making it more suitable for close-in attacks. Flaming shot lowers enemy morale at the cost of reduced damage and reload time, and unsurprisingly, it can't be used in wet weather. Precision shot is an activated ability that increases missile damage for an extended period of time at the cost of fatigue exertion. Elite missile cav units have a couple of interesting and useful traits. Fire whilst moving speaks for itself, but Parthian shot allows units to track and fire upon the enemy in any direction, so they're able to skirmish even when they're being pursued. Alongside their resistance to fatigue, this makes them an incessant thorn in the enemy's side. The Lusitani can field Cantabrian cavalry, a specialist skirmisher unit who ride the finest horses on the Iberian Peninsula. They come with their own distinct attack formation, the Cantabrian Circle, which best exploits their speed and skirmishing skills. The riders maintain a continually rotating circle, making them difficult to pick off and ensuring a continuous shower of javelins on the enemy. This formation is incredibly effective at disrupting infantry lines, and slow-moving heavy troops are their most obvious target. After falling victim to the Cantabrian Circle many times, the Romans later adopted it as a tactic for their own cavalry. Numidian tribesmen were raised with horses from an early age, riding bareback without a bridle. They controlled their horses by tapping the beasts between the ears with a stick. This made Numidian cavalry natural horsemen, and their employment during the Punic Wars was significant. The Battle of Cannae was the high watermark for the Carthaginian military success, and Hannibal's right wing consisted of some 3,500 Numidian cavalrymen. The Numidians attacked the Roman allied cavalry and chased them from the field, before returning to smash into the rear of the Roman infantry lines. Arguably the elite of the Carthaginian army in the Second Punic War, the Numidians' defection under the leadership of Massinissa before the Battle of Zama was instrumental in Scipio's decisive victory over Hannibal. Tarentine cavalry are available to 7 different playable factions in Rome 2, and they have an interesting history. Taranto began as the home of the Parthenii, a colony of Spartans who were exiled due to their impure bloodlines. Fortunately, they bred superb war horses, and its warriors grew in reputation, to the point where Tarentine later became known better for the unit's tactics and weaponry, rather than its geographic origins. Combining well with a slow-moving phalanx, these troops would protect the exposed flanks of the hoplites, and their suitability for this role made them a much sought-after force. That's it for this unit spotlight. We hope we've shed some light on the history and purpose of these units. Tune in again soon for another unit spotlight.